Now, my dear sisters and my brothers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, and welcome to another under 9 minutes brief talk. It is common belief these days that we, the believers, hold a very exclusive and excluding approach towards the world. We are the believers and they are the non-believers. We are the destined to paradise and they are the destined to hellfire. We are eligible to Allah's mercy and the world is not. So much so that in Japan, recently there has been a hurricane that struck Japan, and the Muslim world commented in Arabic that all that happened to Japan was because Allah abhors them, hates them, because they worship other none than Allah. Then Japan wrote back in its official webpage and Facebook, thanks to the Muslim world for standing by our side. What a beautiful smack on the face. So again, we are destined to Allah's everything, and the world is destined to nothing of Allah. How today is very similar to a long time ago, and that long time ago was at the time of the messenger when the Quran was sent down. One day the Jews and Christian of that time, and this is what referred to people of the book, preached and let the world know, especially the Muslims of that time or the believers of that time that believed in Muhammad and the Quran, that Jannah was only for those who were of their ilk, i.e. followers of Judaism and Christianity. Allah reports this in the Quran in the meaning, they say, i.e. the people of the book, be Jews or Christians so you will be guided. So that is, you'll only be guided if you are a Jew or a Christian. Then they further went and claimed that none will enter paradise except one who is a Jew or a Christian. And then Allah answers them back to them and he says that is merely their wishful thinking. And then Allah orders the messenger to say, produce your proof if you should be truthful. Then came our turn, the believers, and those who were present at the time of the messengers, i.e. what's aka known as the companions, were not different than us today. They made the very same mistake that Allah reprimanded the Jews and Christians for making. And that mistake, we're still making it today, even though Allah warned us not to. Well, what did the companions say? They say, paradise is not obtained by any other but them, the believers, i.e. only those who believe in Muhammad and the Quran shall enter paradise. Jews, Christians, everybody else to hellfire. Allah again responded back to them, to those companions, okay? And he says to them, paradise is not obtained by your wishful thinking nor by that of the people of the book. Ya Allah, now the companions are, and the messenger is there. And then Allah establishes the law by which people shall enter paradise, or by which law they will enter hellfire. And he says, whosoever does a wrong, he will be recompensed and rewarded for it. And whoever will not do evil will enter paradise. That's it. In Allah's law, on judgment day, anyone that comes there, having done good, will enter paradise. Having done evil, will enter hellfire. And you have to pay attention to one thing. The companions made the statement that only the believers, wrongly known today as Muslims, because as I said many times, the Jews, Christians, everyone that believes in Allah, in any of his forms, so to speak. We believe in Allah, the Jews believe in Yahweh, whatever they call, the Christians believe in the God, whatever they perceive him to be, the Hare Krishnian, they believe in whatever, anyone who believes in the Supreme High Command up there. It believes in Allah. The only ones that are not Muslims are the atheists that reject the idea of Allah willfully. And even those on judgment day, Allah will deal with them because they have their reasons and purposes why they are the way they are. It's not like they chose to be. It's because of certain elements, and only Allah can say if they did good, or Allah knows the intention, okay? But anyway, back at the time of the companions, the Quran was revealing and they made that statement, knowing that the Jews and the Christians at that time had clearly and openly rejected the messengerhood of Prophet Muhammad, and they rejected the Quran. The Jews stuck to their Bible and to their Torah, and the Christians stuck to their Injil. And even with that, Allah speaks about them as believers in their book. And what has changed from that to this beautiful Islam that is comprehensive, that we accept everybody that believes and Allah holds responsible people? What has made us change from that to being the judgmental people that we are, that today when people see a Jew or Christian or somebody dead, they will say, oh, alhamdulillah that I am not like that. I'm not going to die as a Jew or Christian. Subhanallah. The same mistake. Why? Because one man, and this hadith is reported by Tabarani and also Ibn Majah, and this is a small icing on the cake. One man came to the messenger and he said, and this man was not a believer, okay? And he told the messenger, oh, this is the lie. They lie on the messenger. They said that this man is supposed to have told the messenger, my dad used to be good, nice, he used to feed, he used to, virtually, he mentioned all good things about his dad. And then he asks the messenger, and this man was a disbeliever. He asked the messenger in whom he didn't believe, where is my dad? And he goes, your dad is in hellfire, like that. And as if the Arab man found in himself something, he didn't like it, then the messenger said, and then the man said to the messenger, and where is your dad? And then they say that the messenger said, my dad and your dad in hellfire. Of course, to me, all this is nonsense. It's a huge, big lie. Because the Quran doesn't say this. It's not in the authority of the messenger to decide who goes to hellfire or paradise. And it is not in his authority to be able to do that, because Allah has not held people responsible. Even Allah himself doesn't know who's going to hellfire and who's going to Jannah, unless and until on judgment day, there is the judgment day where Allah is going to hold people responsible. What do you think that is? If Allah knew ahead of time, why would he hold people accountable, then put them there, just chuck them in hellfire and end of it? Okay, that's where. But this hadith, I'm going to tell you something, and I'll cover this more into the science of hadith. Al-Albani, the great Al-Albani, he said the chain of narrators is authentic, and I believe it's true. But the great scholar also, Bin Baz, says, no, this hadith is nonsense, it's a lie. It's not an authentic hadith, cannot be, and I don't even know any chain of narrator for this. And then there has been a boxing glove match between the two. And that's why every time you pass by a graveyard of Jews, Christians and everybody, you go, oh, I give you the good news of hellfire. And this is a lie. This is a direct violation of the command that is in the Quran. And this is why today we are the hateful, judgmental people that we are. We have become gods on earth. Allah says there is judgment day where he's going to hold people responsible, and we decide on people's faiths today based on our assumptions, on what we know externally, that they're going to hellfire. Subhanallah, when Allah wanted Fir'aun to be of the people of hellfire, he mentioned him, Fir'aun, with a name. Everyone else is a person that fulfills the conditions on health of hellfire, and then on judgment day, there is judgment day where people can defend themselves in front of Allah. So from now on, stop being the judgmental person. The Jews are going to hellfire, this going to hellfire, and every time you do that, remember you are in direct violation of Allah's command. So what do I say? I pray to Allah to have mercy on all those people that are dead. From Michael Jackson to Bruce Lee to whoever is dead, to Princess Diana, everyone. I am not God. All I can do is make dua of mercy, and Allah decides on judgment day. I pray to Allah this is clear. And until my next under 9 minutes talk, please be and remain in the mercy of Allah. Salam alaikum.